like many other countries around the world, is currently undergoing an energy transition as we move from largely centralised fossil fuel-fired power stations to a future power system powered by renewable generation and energy storage. As we continue to install lots of solar PV and lots of other renewable generation, we need to install significant amounts of battery storage in order to ensure that we have a secure and reliable supply of electricity. We've already seen uptake of residential batteries in people's homes and utility-scale battery storage installed in the grid. Community batteries complement both residential and utility-scale batteries. A community battery is a medium-sized battery that's installed in your street or in your suburb, and it can provide access to battery storage for up to 100 customers.
So just like any batteries, community batteries store excess energy that's generated during the day from solar to use later in the evening. And the great thing about that is because it's a shared battery, you're storing the energy from houses with solar panels, and that energy can also be used by houses that don't have solar panels.
When we first created large-scale electricity systems, we tended to think of those as largely technical problems. Over time, we added markets, and so we thought of them as techno-economic problems. As we install generation and storage assets in people's homes and in their communities, we've come to realise that these are socio-techno-economic problems.
When you consider the social dimensions of a technology, it's more likely to be able to be rolled out in the real world. So we decided to consider the social questions really early on in thinking through what the technology could and should be.
So what we're doing that's innovative in community batteries is that we've recognised from our social research that different communities will have different needs and expectations of a community battery. So what we've done is written a community battery algorithm that flexibly provide different services and prioritise different services according to a community's specific needs.
A really important finding from the research was that all stakeholders that we spoke to thought that the battery could provide multiple benefits to the energy system and to users. And obviously, the benefits that people emphasised depended on their position in the energy system.
So for grid operators, the community battery can be used to manage power flows from excess solar energy generation during the day and excess electricity demands in the evening and in the morning. For householders like you and I, because we're using our solar energy more effectively, that reduces our bill costs. It also saves us from buying our own batteries. For rural communities, the batteries could present a really useful backup source of power in case of natural disaster, like flood or bushfire. In addition, the batteries can provide a service in reducing the carbon emissions that are produced within a suburb, so it can be effectively used for decarbonisation.
I think what our research revealed is that community batteries have a really important role to play in the energy transition, but that there is a lot at risk as well if it's not done well. It is really incumbent on us as researchers and energy decision makers and policy makers to really consider the whole range of potential impacts that this technology can have.
We've learnt a lot about community batteries through our research so far, and we're now working with community groups, industry and government to see the recommendations from our research put into practice in the real world.